Hey everyone, today I will show you how to configure JavaFX SceneBuilder and IntelliJ IDEA. Alright, to start, let's download SceneBuilder. Search for SceneBuilder. And here, click this link. Just click download now or scroll down. We want this Windows installer. It's on version 19, as you can see. And click download. Open file, click OK, next, click I accept, then next. Remember this install path, or better yet, copy this. We need this later, IntelliJ. Click next, then install. Click finish. Then let's open SceneBuilder. Alright, welcome to JavaFX SceneBuilder. There are a couple of options you can take working with fxml. However, in this video, I'll focus only on how we can configure IntelliJ IDEA and open SceneBuilder from there. What we want to happen is when you select and right click any fxml file like this, you can open it in SceneBuilder from there. Though, as you can see, we have not configured it yet. We need to tell IntelliJ where to find the SceneBuilder executable. So, go to File, Settings, and Language and Frameworks, this one, and click JavaFX. Here, we need to set the path for SceneBuilder. And if you recall, we had that from install location. You just need to paste it here. Well, if you don't have it, just browse and navigate to install location. You just need to select the SceneBuilder executable. And click OK. Apply and OK. Let's try to open this fxml file. And there you go, you are set. And whatever you do here will reflect back to IntelliJ once you save. There are key things to remember. For example, this controller section here is what you specify in your .fxml file. Let's take a look. See this? This is the controller you specify here back in SceneBuilder. This one. Alright, let's run this code. Awesome. Okay, let's run again. If you notice, we are still seeing the label text I am hidden. This one. It's because we have not saved the changes yet. Go to File and Save, or you can do Control S. There, changes has been saved. Let's stop it and run again. Alright, label text I'm hidden is now gone. Okay, next, let's try to do changes directly in fxml. So I just want to show how connected they are. Say, let's change the button text to hello world. Save it, Control S will do again. And go back to SceneBuilder. There you go, our changes reflected right away. Our button has hello world. Alright, that's all. Thank you for watching.